In this video, we will analyze five factors that would cause a demand curve for labor to shift. Previously, we learned about movements along the curve. Next, we will take a look at reasons why it would shift right or left. There are a few factors that would cause a demand for labor to increase or decrease. Let's see what they are. First, we will consider the demand for the good or service that labor is producing. If the demand for the good or service increases, then the derived demand for labor will increase and the labor demand curve will shift right. Conversely, if the demand for the good or service decreases, then the derived demand for labor will decrease and the labor demand curve will shift left. At the end of this video, I'll show you how to draw this shift. Okay, second, we'll discuss government regulations and subsidies. Actions by the government can impact the cost of employment. If subsidies are provided for employment, then the cost of hiring workers will fall and thus result in an increase in the demand for labor. Conversely, if regulation is passed that makes it more expensive to hire workers, labor demand will decrease. Third is the productivity of labor. As the productivity of labor increases, more output is produced per worker, per unit of time. This reduces the cost of production and makes the firm more profitable. They are then increasingly likely to employ more workers, resulting in a rightward shift of the labor demand curve. Fourth is the cost of capital with respect to the cost of labor. The cost of capital can impact how firms employ labor. If capital is a substitute in production for labor, then a rise in the cost of capital will result in greater demand for labor, as it is the cheaper of the two options. Conversely, if capital becomes cheaper with respect to labor, then the demand for labor will fall. Fifth is the impact of a change in price of the final good or service. If the price of the final good rises, ceteris paribus, firms will employ more labor. If the price of the final good falls, ceteris paribus, firms will employ less labor. This is tied to the concept of marginal revenue product of the firm and will be discussed in greater detail in a following video. Next, we'll look at how to draw these changes. Given a labor demand curve DL, we will show what happens when there is an increase in the demand for labor. As you've learned with your demand curve before, this will shift the demand curve to the right. As a demand for labor increases, the demand curve shifts rightward to DL2. At wage rate W1, there is now an increase in the quantity demanded of labor of Q2, but this is along the new demand curve. Using our explanations from before, this could be for a variety of reasons. Suppose this is the demand for labor for workers on a coffee farm. If global demand for coffee rises, more workers will be needed in this industry. Next, let's take a look at what would happen in the same market if the global demand for coffee fell. So the converse is true as well. If global coffee demand falls as consumers switch to drinking more tea, then the demand for labor in the coffee industry will decrease and shift leftwards. At the given wage rate W1, the new quantity demanded for labor is Q2, which is along the new demand curve for labor, DL2. Again, I'd remind you to pay particular attention to how these changes are drawn. It is important to be consistent in drawing your diagrams as this will help you avoid mistakes in the future. Now, here's a chance to test yourself. After the five statements have been revealed, pause the video and attempt to answer whether this would result in an increase or decrease in the demand for labor. I'll review the answers next. Let's see how you did. The instances where labor demand would increase are in green. The situations in which labor demand would decrease are in red. For number one, the publication of this research would likely result in a fall in demand for pizza, thus reducing the demand for the labor producing it. Number two, higher costs of employment would result in firms being less likely to hire workers as they become relatively more expensive. Number three, this new technique improves labor productivity and costs for the firms and makes them more profitable. This would result in higher employment. Number four, The robots would replace workers, thus resulting in a decrease in the demand for labor. And lastly, a successful advertising campaign would likely increase the demand for cheese and products containing cheese, such as pizza. This would result in an increase in the demand for labor in pizza production. If you've learned what you needed to in this video, you'll have gotten all of these questions correct. If you made a mistake, leave a comment below and let's try and figure it out. You should now be able to analyze five factors that could cause a demand curve for labor to shift. Additionally, you should be able to draw such changes and be able to demonstrate the impact on a diagram. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's try to solve them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.